tissue culture. Now, here I just want to introduce you the plant tissue culture lab. More importantly, if somebody wants to know the the economy and the economics behind the tissue culture, how to start a culture lab and what are the benefits and some of the basic requirements. So this lecture, this session will help them to set up a basic tissue culture lab. And also in the end of this this first objective, that is introduction to plant tissue culture lab, sterilization techniques, as you know, that you have pretty good idea about the different kind of sterilization and aseptic techniques. Now I will show you one laboratory practicing sterilization technique method of a reputed, well-reputed company, so you can gain some understanding regarding sterilization techniques. And it is more about running a lab rather than just theory. So here I start the need of low-cost lab. Low-cost option and the low-cost production is always an attractive idea, is an attractive approach where you can maintain the quality of plants. You can go for micropropagation in a very cheap rate. Low-cost tissue culture technology is a high priority in several sectors related to plant sciences, such as agriculture, horticulture, forestry, floriculture, which is an emerging domain in this field, and many developing countries are actually looking for to develop a low-cost lab so that they can feed, they can supply the need of that particular area or a particular community at a specific time period. So now in this slide, I have the general requirement for set up a low cost laboratory. So this is a general laboratory map, just like how you make one's home or a house. It is just a map like this. This is an entry, and this is an ideal picture. If somebody wants to start a lab, they first need an area of some 20 by 15 or 12 meter by 10 meters. This is an ideal configuration to start a tissue culture lab. Media preparation area is there. I mean, chemical store area, that analytical instruments, dark room, photography room. These rooms are necessary, as I said in my last lecture, that if you go for a tissue culture laboratory or a tissue culture experiments, in every stage, you need good quality photographs. And good quality photographs mean not only your camera, it's all about the background also. Fine, this photography is also an art. And this is a sterilization area where you, that dissection room, or you can keep your laminars here. Adjacent to this dissection room or laminar flow room, this is a wash-up room is here. And this is a bigger area which constitutes around 40 to 50% of the total single room is a culture room with cells. And in all these areas, there should be some exhaust. Exhausting machinery should be implemented all over the room. Location. Location is an important aspect. The location shall conform to the land use plan of the area. And the main prerequisite that this location should be contamination free. Fine. It should not be in that area where much of the dirt, much of the soil sands used to come through the air. So it should be, it's a kind of some hiding place. The site should be accessible to service roads, and it is well supplied with water and electricity lines. You know, just 2 days line cut will make your whole experimental setup spoil. and the sites should be well drained. So the structural requirement, you all know that India observe, our country observe 6 different kind of seasons. So every season has its own flavor, own pleasure, but the room, the culture room should be of in such a way it should be prepared, it should be developed so that it can suffer the changing weather conditions. It should not be damped. Fine. It should not absorb water during the rainy season. Otherwise, there is a chance of fungal infection. So these all things should be kept in mind when you go for a development of a tissue culture laboratory. The next one is functional requirement. So these are the basic facility for laboratory. Working place, washing room, sterilization, as I have shown in the layout of that particular room. Inoculation, incubation, media preparation, all the rooms should be in a separate manner and it should be well aerated and contamination free. Washing, you all know that different kind of chemicals should be used for washing. I am not going into that which kind of chemicals, because already you know that and we have a small discussion. But the main point is here that washing sink, it should be of 45 centimeter to 60 centimeter. This is a minimum requirement. And it should be made up of good quality steel or marble, so that it can resist different kind of acidic and alkali. Fine. And the room, that washing room, should be provided with bucket, detergent, mug, plastic tray, everything should be there. Now, for detergent purpose, we actually use liquid detergent. That trade name is Lavoline. Generally, we use Lavoline in our labs. And the sterilization room, should be the must contain one autoclave, hot air oven. There should be sometimes we used to place a small shaker also there in the sterilization room, but it is not mandatory. And media preparation room. This is an important area where all the food, all the things, all the stuffs are prepared for your further experimentation. That table, I am talking about, not about media. I am talking about the table on which you are going to prepare it. This should be of 1.2 meter wide. This is a general requirement. And the height should be around 1 meter from the surface. And the water sources and glassware storage area shall be provided with it. And the room should contains a stock and it is well labeled. Remember, you budding tissue culturist, that labeling and the recording is actually a very much mandatory during your tissue culture experiments, because this labeling will help you to identify which chemical if you suddenly required a certain chemical and it is not labeled, it is difficult for you to find out. Inoculation room. The room should contain airflow cabinet and with the installation of HEPA. Fine. What is HEPA? It is high efficiency particulate air and filter for filtered air supply. It also requires sodium hypochlorite, HgCl2, 70% ethanol for surface sterilization, not only the explant, the start material, but also the area should be cleaned. This is an incubation room. The width of the racks should be 0.5 meter to 1 meter. Fine. The distance between each layer of racks should be not less than 455 millimeter. This is a standard requirement as prescribed by several agencies. And the photopeered racks with culture bottle shall be provided. It mostly operate light intensity with a standard day length of 16 hours and a night of 8 hours. That is called 16 by 8 or 8 by 16 and by D. Fine, while you are writing or preparing a practical report. Temperature is, you know, 25 degrees centigrade is a standard temperature, and AC should be fitted to maintain the temperature, and light intensity around 20 lux to 1600 lux for the growth of culture. It depends upon the type of culture, the type of explant which is needed. Instrumentation room. General instruments like magnetic stirrer, pH meter, UV tube, thermometer, all should be at one place. I am just giving one live example. This time the temperature of Delhi NCR is around 46, 47 degrees centigrade. And this is a pretty good temperature to make error in all those instruments. So the instrument room must contain an AC which maintains the temperature not more than 32 degrees centigrade. Otherwise it creates problem, it starts creating error for your experiments. The most affected one will be pH meter and weighing balance. And glassware and other requirements are listed here, like glass bottle, petri dishes, burette, funnel, beaker, pipette, spatula, forceps, wrapping paper, filter paper. These all are required for your day-to-day experiments. Now I come to the main economy, the main budget for to start this lab is, it is a general idea, like glasswares, chemicals, aluminium. It costs around 60 to 70,000. This is the minimum requirement to start a general tissue culture lab. And these are the instruments. The list of instruments can be more, but I am just trying to keep the minimum requirement to start a laboratory, provided that that room is given to you. Fine. And this instrument costs around 1 lakh 10 thousand, and so it's around 1 lakh 50 thousand to 1 lakh 60 thousand. This is the minimum low cost requirement to start a tissue culture laboratory. Fine, if you are an expert of this area. The other facilities should be hand washing facilities, and this fire extinguishing system should be there if you are started inside a academic institution. So this facilities is already given to you, but if you are going for an independent setup, then this you have to manage. Fine. And waste disposal area, you know, there are some ethical guidelines associated with the waste disposal. Fine. Because there is a possibility that you are analyzing, you are testing some harmful gene. And without proper disposal, if you just throw outside the laboratory or in a playground or in a general garbage system, there is a chance that that gene, that effect of that gene will enter in our food chain through vertical transfer of gene. So it should be avoided. If something is very much harmful, it is first incinerated, it is first flamed or destroyed with the help of autoclaving machine. Then only it is disposed of. So this you should remember, that this is an important aspect of any tissue culture lab or in general, any laboratory practices. These are called GLP, that is good lab practices. going to show you this video. I don't know how it comes. Aruba ma'am, is this thermos feature into the
sterile environments, working slowly and deliberately, and following all of the guidelines for sterile technique? Always wear basic personal protective equipment, or PPE, when working in the laboratory. Talk to the safety team at your institute for your required PPE. Also, remember to review the MSDS information before working with any media or reagent.
So participants, it will be a good experience for you to see a laboratory and how you start any kind of laboratory work, especially the tissue culture. Now, coming to the next session, the next short session on plantae body. So the argument to develop an antibody from plant is not new. It starts in late 80s, where the plants were start considering as a good bioreactor because of their low cost maintenance. The tissue culture, if we use the animal system or any animal tissue culture system, it increases the cost by 10 times or 20 times. And the hybridoma technology, which was also a very, very good technology, a very good insight to fight any kind of new disease or new, even the cancers. Fine, but these technology were not cheap and the production cost is very high. Even the newer system for isolation of protein and the purification of protein is going day by day cheaper with the advent of several new technologies. But still, these technology are, when coupled with this plantae body, makes your target protein cheaper and can be commercialized in a very lower cost. So what are plantae bodies? A plantae body is an antibody which is produced by genetically modified plants. Here the concept of GMO, the concept of genetic engineering will play its role. Fine, because the protein is an expression of a stretch of DNA or gene. It means the gene is responsible for the production of protein. Fine, and if that gene, that stretch of DNA is present in animal or in a microbe or in any other system, they have their own machinery. With the help of that machinery, they produce correct conformation protein. Fine, so the changing of this system from the parent system to this plant was analyzed and it was assessed and tested that yes, this is a technology which can be proven very useful for the production of large amount of protein, the target protein or any protein which is useful. Fine. So successfully completed in 1989, such kind of projects were first successfully completed in 1989, when mouse antibody was developed in tobacco plant, Nicotiana tabacum. Fine. Although plants do not naturally make antibody, that is for sure. Plants do not naturally produce antibody. Why? You know, there is a big difference between plant and animal. Although we have legs to move, but we are very much prone to attack from several microbes, several fungus, and several other changing environment. So this antibody is generated in our body to confront, to make our body safer. But this antibody is not present in plant. The plant system, they does not have any defined immune system. Fine. So naturally, this antibody is not going to produce through plant naturally. So there's a concept of genetically modified plant where that particular gene is incorporated into the plant with the help of certain techniques. And after going to inside the genome, adding to the genome of this plant, they start giving its expression. Fine. So the term plantae body, as well as the concept of trademark by the company in Biolex. So I am showing here the antibody factory. So plants are being used as antibody factory using their endomembrane and secretory system to produce large amount of clinically viable protein. Why I'm using this term viable? Because a protein is functional only when it is correctly folded. If a protein is not correctly folded, it is functionless. It's not going to give any kind of function. Fine. So antibody can be expressed in plant, either in a full-length molecule or as smaller fragments. If the protein molecule is big, so we cannot rely on plant. So we can use the small fragments of protein gene and express in separate plants. And after, with the help of some biotechnological method, all the chains, all the chains of proteins are being merged to make that functional protein. This part is somehow not cost effective, but yes, the things are going on. Antibodies are produced in plant for both human therapeutic process purpose and protection of plant against disease. Both are the cases. In case of transgenic plant, which is being developed against locust worm, several viruses, they contains the expressible protein from somewhere else, so that they can protect themselves. This I will again discuss in my later sessions. So the I have making a list here. Antibody type like IgG from different kind of animals like human, herbs. So these all are full size monoclonal antibody which is produced in through plant. So methods for plant antibody production using transformation and transient expression. This transient expression means local expression. I mean, you don't need to transform to use the basic tissue culture method to generate the GMO. You just use needleless and express your gene inside the leaf. And after 5 days or 7 days, they start producing the protein. You can cut the leaf and you can check whether it is being used everywhere now. Now targeting to the apoplasm by the tagging with small peptide sequences. Signal molecule added to target the protein to the endoplasmic reticulum to ensure correct folding of the protein. Higher protein level is obtained in endoplasmic reticulatum and apoplasm as compared to cytosol because of their good machinery. So these are two methods through which we can produce plant antibody. One is transformation with the help of gene gun or agrobacterium mediated approach. And second one is targeting apoplasm. These two are I have shown here the help of ray diagrams. This is a plant protoplast. I mean, there's no cell wall. That particular one space, it is tagged. And after the regeneration, this plant you will get. And after the plant is, when it is developed, it is tested through several molecular and immunological techniques to ensure that whether the target gene, the target protein is correctly expressed or not. And if it is expressing, the folding is okay or not. I mean, there are so many testing. Only then it is approved by the competent authority and it can be now go for commercial production of that particular protein. And this is apoplasmic a way to express the foreign protein. The main part is purification, because once you express the protein, you have to purify. You have to purify so that the purified protein can be used. So nowadays, as I have already said, that there are so many available methods nowadays using which you can cheaply purify the large quantity of protein. And there is no risk of spreading animal disease to human as the antibodies are produced by a plant. This is one of the biggest advantage when we use plant as a bioreactor. And the production of large amount of clinically viable protein, especially IgA, has many application in medicine. And in India, the there are several companies in Pune and Maharashtra. They are producing plant antibodies. One is Bharat Biotech, and I think Cipla is also using some kind of plant antibody production. So these are just the outline of the techniques for purification of plant antibody, that is filtration. Chromatography is the most general technique which has been used all over the world. Polymer fusion. And to evaluate, I already said that aapne plant to grow kar liya, but whether it is giving expression, matlab translation correct ho raha hai ki nahi, then you have to check. Then you have to go for molecular biology techniques such as Northern blot and other immunological techniques such as ELISA and couple of immunomolecular techniques, that is immunofluorescence stacked Southern blot analysis. Fine. So Northern blot is for to identify what? RNA. How you remember this? You just tried SNOW and you know the central dogma, that is DNA to RNA, RNA to protein. Write this and write SNOW. SNOW, S for Southern blot, it is for DNA. N for Northern blot, it is for RNA. And W for Western blot, and this is for protein. Fine. So this all you can remember, that which particular blot, which particular hybridization is used to identify which molecule. Fine. So secretory IgG. I have said that if the protein is having more than one chain or it is very large, so different chains are produced in different plants and it is finally tagged with some method to produce the functional protein. So this most abundant IgG, that is immunoglobulin in the body, protects the mucosal surfaces. Each component is made by separate transgenic plant. Plants are then crossed to give multimeric molecule, that is a functional molecule, and protection to the hepatitis virus and other disease. This is being used since 90s. And if you remember, the cost of this hepatitis vaccine suddenly dropped down from 1500 rupees to 50 rupees. This is just because using such kind of techniques. And you know which plant we can use? The plant which is easily available, the plant which is easy to maintain, and the plant whose regeneration capability is high and whose life cycle is short. That plants like tobacco. Tobacco is an excellent model system to express the foreign gene and also for several analytical experiments related to tissue culture, related to molecular biology, related to genetic engineering. So plant seeds is also an attractive storage organ for plant antibody. You know, if some protein is accumulated inside the seed, it is a boon, because that protein is in an accumulated form and this protein can be easily purified. So this tobacco and some plants where the target protein can be stored inside the seed are generally used for the production of this plant antibody. So I have already said the production cost for antibody. If we go for hybridoma, this is an older data, but you can develop some idea ki kis tarah se kam ho raha hai cost. If you go for hybridoma, then cost is $1,000 per gram. If you go for transgenic animal system or a animal tissue culture system, the cost lower down to $100 per gram. And if you go for transgenic plant, it is like just 1% to that hybridoma technology. So we can cut short the cost and we can earn revenue with the help of this system. Thank you.